This is the last dam on the Colorado River. From here on, there are no more dams. But of course, pretty much from here on, there isn't any more water either. Five years ago, here at Morelos Dam, the gates were opened for really the first transboundary environmental flow, I think, anywhere. And what that flow, called the pulse flow, was intended to do was to try to recreate some of the spring flood that happened down here before all the dams were constructed on the Colorado River. You could really call it a big landscape scale experiment. We wanted to find out how many trees and other vegetation would spring up, and we wanted to find out, was that enough water to reach the Gulf of California? I lost my bet. I didn't think it would. Other people did, and they won.
I saw the pulse flow in action. It was really exciting because my husband had our son in a backpack. So the three of us were like trying to find the little stream moving forward. It was by the sunset that we got to be there, and my son was playing in the sand and seeing the water moving, and it was amazing.
Para las comunidades de la región fue una fiesta. Durante el tiempo que duró el flujo pulso, los medios de comunicación locales, la ciudadanía, las redes sociales, no hablaron de otra cosa, y sobre todo fue muy bonito que la gente reconociera que el río Colorado forma parte de la identidad de todos los habitantes de esta región.
One third of the water comes from the NGOs who buy or lease water rights from Mexican farmers. One third of the water comes from the US side, and one third of the water comes from the country of Mexico. This is a binational project. And in a time when, you know, you'd think tensions between the U.S. and Mexico would be high, you come to the Delta and people sort of really collaborate with each other from both sides of the border in this project.
Okay. We're all set?
Yeah. You have the
thing? What we've been doing is some repeat photography where we've reoccupied some sites where photographs were taken of the landscape just before the pulse flow in 2014, just to see how much it changed in the past 5 years, and also as a record of sort of conditions today as a way of telling us 5 years from now how much things might have changed.
I think it can be challenging sometimes to find the exact location, especially because we're using GPSs that have some error. Also, there were markers set up, but it's really hard to keep your markers in these areas.
En este momento están en el sitio de restauración Miguel Alemán. Toda esta zona era una zona donde era un antiguo meandro del río Colorado. Aquí la gente, los pobladores, venían a esta zona a pescar. Después venían también a hacer actividades recreativas con sus familias. Y bueno, dejó de correr agua por esta zona, por lo tanto, toda la vegetación nativa se secó. Lo que quedó fue pura arena y pino salado, que es una especie que no es nativa de la región. Muchas de las poblaciones, particularmente de aves y de peces, sus poblaciones se han reducido y en algunos casos se han extinguido. El esfuerzo de plantación de 2014 a la fecha es aproximado a 100,000 árboles. Y la superficie que se ha restaurado al día de hoy es de 100.5 hectáreas.
The Delta is along the Pacific Flyway, a major migratory pathway. So sometimes they say if you're a duck hunter in North Dakota, you should care about the Delta because your ducks come through here and they stop here and they bulk up, they feed and they drink then they fly further on. So it's not just a local issue, it's regional, and a pretty large region at that.
Antes del flujo pulso, teníamos una abundancia de 40 especies. Ahorita ya estamos un poquito más de 100. Y eso sucede en casi todos los sitios de restauración.
Es muy importante también la parte de los beneficios sociales que genera la restauración, porque gran parte de la derrama económica de los esfuerzos que se generan de este trabajo, pues quedan en San Luis Río Colorado y en su valle, y también generamos importantes fuentes de empleo para los pobladores de las comunidades cercanas.
We're at a site called Yanitzio, and it's a site that Pro Natura plans to use in the future for restoration purposes. What we're looking at here is actually an old meander of the Colorado River. It's been completely dried out. And the reason we're here is to sort of record what this place looked like before the restoration activities began. In about 5 years' time, my hope that this is going to look like the Miguel Alemán site that has 5 years of growth of cottonwoods and willows, basically a wall of green in the middle of this dry plain. I started studying the Delta in 1992 when I visited some sites in the northern Gulf of California. And the students and I were along on that trip just exploring. And we found these beaches that were just made of completely of shells. And one of the most puzzling things we found, or didn't find, I guess, is we couldn't find very many live individuals of the species that we were finding as dead shells. And we couldn't figure that out until we realized the whole environment of the Upper Gulf of California had changed. The salinity of the Upper Gulf had gone up, and this species liked fresher water than is there now. So I gradually became part of, I'll say, the Delta community. And one of the attractions, really, of the Delta community is I really like all the people. And I like working with a project of this scale that I would say 20 or certainly 30 years ago, nobody thought was possible.
We are in the middle of Laguna Grande restoration area, and it has more than 700 acres of riparian forest. This is cottonwoods and willows, and it's the densest and largest riparian forest along the river in Mexico. If we look around, all this forest wasn't here 5 years ago. Mexicali, which is the closest city, is a large city, and it's mostly industrial, so kids and people are used to being inside. And when we bring school kids here, even when they just step off the school bus, it's a very big surprise. And we've gotten kids from the normal excitement, like saying, wow, what is this place, to kids crying. We are planting a little seed of curiosity to be in touch with nature again.
When you look at the actual amounts of water that are being delivered here through this agreement compared to the amounts of water that go to agriculture in the United States or agriculture in Mexico, to cities in the US, to cities in Mexico, this is really a teeny little drop. And that teeny little drop is doing an enormous amount of good. People ask me sort of how much water would it take to restore the Delta, and I have to turn the question around and say, well, how much nature do you want? That's a societal values kind of question. The whole Delta's not going to be restored simply because agriculture is too important, the cities are too important. But I think we can afford enough water to restore a ribbon of green from the border almost to the Gulf.
La restauración es posible si hay capacidad y voluntad de los gobiernos acompañados de la sociedad civil. Sí es posible poder sentarse a buscar una solución en la cual pueda ser considerado el medio ambiente una parte fundamental.